Okay, welcome back. Time to talk about the beach soccer, Eco Beach Soccer
Eco
precisely.
Beach Soccer Fiesta.
What went down, stationery stores are the ones who emerged the winners of this particular
Edition,
edition,
right?
that happened at the mini tournament. 16 features in it. The chairman of the Eco Beach Soccer talking about Tadi Aziz, he says the competition is actually geared towards improving the sport in Lagos, and hopefully maybe someday we can just have a beach soccer league in Nigeria. But this
Interesting.
one is just for Lagos.
Yeah, mini tournament. Cecilia, very competitive final as well, too. 5-4 ended in favor of Shooting Stars. Stationery Stars. 5-4 against Freestyle. Freestyle FC. Cecilia, usually when you hear Stationery Stars, I mean, it brings back the memories. And you want to see them playing and competing at the highest level. Of football in the country, but
on the pitch now.
On the pitch, not on the sand, right? But it's good to see the name of the club still well and alive.
Yeah, that's the way it is. Let's listen to the chairman of Eco Beach Soccer talking about Mr. Tadi Aziz.
The objectives actually are many. The first one, of course, is to say a big thank you to people like Channels, our friends and family, football family, so they can come and have fun with us. Our second objective. The third is to actually get our beach soccer players to actually play and let people see that we have beach soccer players in Lagos. And the fourth is to prepare people's minds for the Eco Football, Eco Beach Soccer League coming up again, resuming this year. If you look at this particular tournament, I've been looking at the players, and I'm honest with you when I say that the quality of football, beach soccer that we're seeing today, is at least 100% better than we saw last year.
We are still spreading the gospel, telling Lagosians that a lot we can do on our beaches, telling footballers that those that cannot make regular 11 aside teams can make something in this beach soccer thing. It has more than the quality to promote the thing. And what we are hoping to achieve, because we are the only state that plays beach soccer regularly in Nigeria, what we are hoping to achieve is to have the whole bunch of players playing for Nigeria drawn from Lagos beach soccer league.
Thank you very much.
That's the way it is. Lagos is the state that is very active playing beach soccer. Hopefully other states can actually take a cue. That's if they have a beach, to play on. First, we listen to Shea Akin, who is the second vice president of Nigerian Football Federation. And then Tadi Aziz, who is the president of Nigerian Referee Association, but then he's more like a versatile one. All right, we'll just welcome our guest, talking about Toby Olubi. He's in the studio. Good morning. Good to have you.
Good morning, guys. It's always good to be here.
It's great to have you, Toby.
Yeah.
We want to continue our countdown now to the Commonwealth Games now. Just one day to go. I think if you just looking around and asking a few questions, expectations not too high.
Not too high. I think it just has to be. With probably the level of the competition that is the Commonwealth Games, it doesn't get the attention that I think it deserves. And you hardly hear people talking about it on like the Olympics, which people like to give a force and everything about. But Nigeria is being represented in 10 sports. You know, about 90 athletes are going and 45 officials. So wrestling is the most hopeful. You know, I saw some posts on social media when they got to Australia, and that there's a lot of high hopes in the camp as well from the wrestlers. And there's this very good statistic that 12 out of the last 36 medals in the last Commonwealth Games were gotten by the wrestling team. So it just shows that going into this one in Australia would have high hopes.
A lot of hopes to get on the wrestling
medals.
Team.
Yep,
on right. The wrestler. Okay, let's just see that.
You're not even looking at other sports at all.
Okay.
Yeah.
Other sports,
athletics, basketball, wrestling, weightlifting, table tennis, para-athletics, powerlifting, and gymnastics.
Yeah.
You know, that's a surprising one for me. We are being represented in gymnastics. But I think powerlifting,
right.
I think we've always been successful in that. And I'm expecting 1, 2, 3, or 4 medals coming from in there. Table tennis as well. We seem to be able to dominate Africa in table tennis. And, you know, I'm quite optimistic that we'll get a few medals from some of these competitions.
Optimistic is the word, and a lot of hoping being done by Nigerians are going into the Commonwealth Games in the Gold Coast. So let's just refresh and go through some of the guys that will be representing Nigeria in the competition. Cecilia, let's start with boxing. Boxing used to be that sport that was really good back in the days, and the glory days, you have to say, are long gone, and people are trying to bring it back. But we'll see how it pans out. Cecilia, for the female Yes. You have the likes of Aisha Oriyomi, who will be competing in that particular event, 51 kg flyweight category. You also have Yetunde Odunuga, 60 kg, Itunu Oriola, 69 kg, as well as Millicent Agbegbolem in the 75 kg, that's middleweight. And for the guys, you have Sikiru Fatai Aja Ojo, 56 kg bantamweight. You also have Kazim Shoyoye, 50 kg lightweight. Osita Ume, 69 kg. And Lukman Lawal, 81 kg light heavyweight category. So these are some of the guys that Nigerians are looking up to get medals for the country.
Yeah, for the table tennis, also looking forward to these guys also, all male. Remember what happened in the female?
Funny issues. I never understand that
to
one.
Win medals. Okay, have Segun Terriola, Aruna Quadri, Bode Abiodun, Chide Omotayo, and Jimmy Aziz, regular name. So Nigeria will be competing in the singles team and also doubles event. So whatever happens, doubles event, you might just get something. Teams event may be something, but singles, I think Aruna Quadri will just be the one everyone will be looking up to get something in that one.
It's like the best in Africa at the moment. Except for the Egyptian, is nightmare. You know, I hope this time he's gonna make us proud.
Hopefully he can do that.
All the best to the guys, Team Nigeria. Wish you all the best in the competition in the Gold Coast. Let's talk about Cecilia. Let's talk about the Falcons.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, getting ready for that a marquee friendly, however, the prestige friendly against France.
I mean, I've been
you know, like, excited like this because I can't remember the last time the Falcons played such a friendly match.
Have they ever?
I doubt it.
I need to go through the history book to check it and see if they've ever, you know, played a major international friendly like this. I mean, against a country like France.
Perhaps they have long time ago.
Perhaps they have maybe long time ago.
But
when
not recently,
started,
definitely.
But obviously not in the last 5 years. Mm. I haven't seen that. But this is really a cool one.
Yeah.
You know, I love the fact that, okay, it was 17 players that were invited. Now we saw Sophia Omidiji. I mean, she's been invited also. So that makes about 18 players. I don't know if they're going to invite more. But then today, that's when all of them are supposed to report to camp. Then on Friday, that's when they will play the game. Well,